thank you for joining us. I'm Anaridis Rodriguez with the WBZ News Update. Our top stories today: icy roads slowing drivers across the state. Mass DOT says it has nearly 1,000 crews treating the roads, and they've posted signs on the highways warning of the icy conditions. Part of 495 was shut down overnight and has since been reopened near Franklin to treat the roads. Drivers are being encouraged to take it slow, as conditions are expected to remain dangerous through most of the day. A Fall River apartment complex on edge after a pipe bomb goes off in the parking lot, followed by a second suspicious package discovered on site, forced the complex to be evacuated for a second time in a 24-hour stretch. Nobody was hurt, but you could see damage to the car as well as a blown-out tire. Police are now searching for a suspect. The man charged in a deadly pizza shop crash in Newton will head to trial next year. Brad Kassler appeared in court Friday for the first time since rejecting a plea deal. He rejected a deal that would have sent him to jail for 2 years. Instead, Kassler's trial will begin on May 7th. In March of 2016, Kassler's SUV crashed into the Sweet Tomatoes restaurant in Newton, killing two people who were inside. Kassler blames the accident on his multiple sclerosis. We turn our attention to the weather. Meteorologist Barry Burbank is taking a look at the forecast. Barry, a lot of accidents already reported into the morning from the overnight hours.
Yeah, it was very slippery out there. We had that glazing situation. Hi, Anaridis. Hi, everybody. Here's what's going on. So it's all about the ice and the glazing, which took place last night, and lingering icy weather this morning, and more ice buildup on some cold surfaces as the day goes along. So very slippery on untreated surfaces. Where the surfaces have been treated, where the roads have been treated, they're basically wet or just a few slick spots. Other places which have not been treated are just a glaze, a sheet of ice. Improving conditions from southeast to northwest during the day, and it looks like there will be a risk of a few to several inches of snow on Christmas morning. So that's your Christmas weekend headlines. Looks like we've had that glazing across this pink shaded area here. The brighter pink indicative of where there'll be additional ice buildup coming up for today, as we have these temperatures slow to rise over north central Massachusetts, but rising more quickly near the coast. No icing issues on Cape Cod whatsoever. As the mild air starts coming in from the ocean, it's going to push this cold air out, but it's going to run into a lot of resistance as the mild air comes in. So the cold air is going to stay entrenched in north central Massachusetts, where the most ice buildup will occur from the rain, which turns moderate later this morning and into the afternoon hours as we get those yellow shades coming up there. So that means there'll be some ice buildup there. It may actually perhaps go up into the upper 40s to near 50 degrees in Boston by late this afternoon or early this evening as we get into the warm sector. And then the cold air comes back in with some more showers later this evening. And then by morning, we're down into the upper 20s near 30 degrees. And then it looks like tomorrow we'll have a mix of sunshine and clouds with some high clouds coming in during the day, but it should be just fine. For the game at Gillette Stadium, should be around 38 degrees with a north-northeast breeze at 5 to 10 miles an hour. Then we get the snow on Christmas morning, as much as 3 to 6 inches just near northwest and west and southwest of Boston, but mostly rain over southeastern Massachusetts and the Cape. That's for Christmas morning, but it's moving very quickly, so it'll be clearing up by midday on Christmas, and the rest of the year looks to be absolutely frigid. That's your forecast for now. Anaridis?
All right, Barry, thank you. I'm Anaridis Rodriguez. This has been a WBZ News Update. Have a good day.